rotate at the same speed but counterwise or clockwise. And you take one electron here and you take the other to Seattle or to the moon, and the moment you put them in the same axis, they rotate counterwise or clockwise. This is faster than the speed of light. There is no way there can be communication. The universe is indivisible. It is akhand. That was the definition of Brahma. Brahma spoke of consciousness, this urja being pervaded by consciousness. I'm giving you snapshots only, the rest is in the book. This consciousness. Today, scientists, be it Nobel laureates like Max Planck, Edwin Schrodinger, they are saying that consciousness is primary, what is material is derivative. That this great energy cannot exist without a foundational consciousness underpinning it, of which we are a part and everything else is a part. Everything is a manifestation of that consciousness. I am not saying it. Nobel laureate physicists who have studied it and have come to a full stop where science stops are putting down in cold ink on paper that there is a primary consciousness pervading the universe. Brahm spoke of Atman and Brahm being the same. Today, in Harvard, in neurology labs, experiments are being carried out of those who practice meditation. One of them is very interesting. It is done by Andrew Newberg in a book which is written called Why God Won't Die. Here is a practice meditation.
Switch it off.
Who, just before he is going into the deepest meditation, has a string tied to his finger. And there are scientists now in this neurology lab behind the panel, and just as he's about to slip into the deepest moments of meditation, he gives a little tug on that finger, alerting the scientists, and they are carrying out a SPECT of his brain. And they find how the colors of the brain begin to change. And the most active area of the brain, which is called the association area, that begins to acquire cooler colors of blue and green, softer colors. And then these scientists have concluded that the world is animated by something called absolute unitary being. And that in fact consciousness within us, there is an inherent ability within us of a material substance called the brain to produce a transcendence which transcends that materialism of the brain. In other words, there is an observer within us. And when that observer goes into deep meditation, all barriers that are man-made, all divisions, all sense of I-ness merges, diffuses, dissolves into a sense of complete identification with an all-pervasive consciousness. That has been demonstrated by science. So I have tried to show, without reducing such analogies to the level of what I call the Dinanath Bhatra school of history, to actually try and understand whether what somebody saw through a philosopher's eye is being validated by what scientists are seeing today through microscopes and telescopes. And there is a correlation. And that is one of the most remarkable things that you can give credit to the great philosophers and seers and sages who have given the foundation to Hinduism as we know it. So we began with Bhaja Govindam. And I will end with it, because what does he say? And I want to give an example here. In Bhaja Govindam, Adi Shankaracharya says, Shariram Swarupam సదా రోగముక్తం సుచారు చరిత్రం ధనం మేరుతుల్యం. యు మే హ్యావ్ అ బ్యూటిఫుల్ బాడీ, శరీరం స్వరూపం, సదా రోగముక్తం అండ్ రిమైన్ ఆల్వేస్ హెల్దీ. సుచారు చరిత్రం, బీ లోడెడ్ ఫర్ యువర్ క్యారెక్టర్. ధనం అండ్ బీ వెల్దీ ఇనఫ్ లైక్ ద మౌంటైన్ ఆఫ్ మేరు, యువర్ ట్రెజర్స్. మనుష్యనే writes the most lyrical hymn of bhakti. But the same Shankaracharya, and I will end with this, in Nirvana Shatakam says, Namai raga dvesha, namai moha lobha, mado naiva mai naiva matsarya bhava, na dharmo na chartho na kamo na moksha. He denies all the four purushats of Hinduism. What remains? Chidananda Rupa,
Shivoham, Shivoham.
In this and awareness, I am Shiva, I am Shiva. Na punyam, na papam, na sokhyam, na dukham, na mantram, na tirtham, na vedo, na yajna. There is no mantra, there is no tirth, there is no ved, there is no yajna. Aham bhojyanam neva bhojyam na bhokta. Chidananda
Rupa, Shivoham, Shivoham.
This is the truth, this is the truth. Namaya Mrityu Shankar. And look at what he said about the Guru, and this is what he says now. Namai Mrityu Shanka, Namai Jati Bheda. Pita Naiva Mai Naiva Mata Na Janma. I'm neither father nor mother, nor was I ever born. Na Bandhur Na Mitram, Guru Naiva Shishya. There is neither Bandhur nor Mitram, nor Guru nor Shishya. The same man who wrote Tathakim, Tathakim, Tathakim. This is the remarkable iconoclasm of great thinkers. Only thing that remains, Chidananda Rupa,
Shivoham.
Thank you so much.